Welcome back to the video, guys. This is now part 4. We are now going to design or complete our design on form number 3. As I've said, we may need another form to view the invoices later on. So let's see what we have in form number 3. But remember, we're gonna need most of this data. So in the meantime, I'll just keep it on the clipboard by copying it. Then I'm going to customers, and I will do those basic things I was talking about. Changing this to be the background of white. Then changing sizable here to fixed tool window. And removing the underscore on the text here. Just put a space. And then I will then change the start position to actually start at center screen. From there, I'm left with two things. Change the minimize and maximize box to be false. Lastly, we actually need the size of this form. Okay, I'm gonna copy the size of this form. Just have a feeling that this one, since it's smaller, let's rather copy the size of this one. There we go. Then we can then go copy the context of this form. This is to make sure that our forms are similar. When we move from one form to the other, it doesn't look like we've actually changed the application. So from there, the back to menu and the clear data we're going to keep together with the save. We're just going to change the context of what is inside here based on what our database is saying on customers. So let's have a look at customer table. So we have full names, gender, email, phone, and physical address. So it's quite a lot. I think it's about one more than what I had previously. So we might need to be moving this a little bit to the top to accommodate for one last value. There we go. This is a copied version of color. Okay, my computer is a little bit slow. Okay, so let's start. We're saying full names. Okay, you can see full names no longer appear very nicely, so I'm gonna have to move it this side. And then from full names we have gender. From gender we then had email and phone. Lastly, we had the physical address. Physical address is also a very long name. I only see my goals, I don't believe in failure, 'cause I know the I'm going to align this thing based on the last letter. And I'm going to try to increase the size of each ear. Maybe to match this, I'm not sure. Just thinking, maybe this could be enough, especially for emails and the physical address. Lastly, I'm going to make sure that I've also aligned them to the center. And the center I'm talking about is the center from this direction of physical address and this direction. Okay, everything here I'm happy with. Let's change the variable names now. So remember, we're still dealing with text boxes. So the first one is full names. We'll have the email. So for physical address, I'm gonna just write it like this. Okay, we are almost done. As I've said, later on we'll then go see the data in the database, but for now, this is I'm happy with these designs. Our first form, which looks like this, our second form, our third form. Obviously, we might want to have a login page later on and things like that, but for now, let's just focus on what we said we're gonna do. So both of our forms, let's make sure that at least from menu, we are able to move around. So this is the first programming we're doing up to so far. So when you're in menu and you click add customer, it's a button. We want to make sure we take you to the name of the form called add custom. So it's @_customers. So we'll just say go to, right? I usually just come up with new variable names here. So this variable, it can be anything, right? You can call it go to form. That becomes my variable name, right? So go to form becomes my variable name. And remember, you must write exactly the name of the form you want to navigate to. Right, so we were here, we double click here, we want to go to add customer. Add customer, this is the form name of the form. So you need to write it down to say add customer, give it a variable name, like an instant, you are creating an instant of this form. Then you can then say the name of the variable, go to form your instant dot show, right? You are viewing the new form now, but the previous one must be closed. So you will say the one which is active, which is this dot, right? This will make sure that that form is closed. So let me just show you what this does to our program. Okay, so this is how it runs. Again, I'm gonna minimize so that we see. So from here, if you press add customer, it opens a new form, and that other previous form is nowhere to be found, right? So we're left with saying when we click menu, it must take us back to the menu form. Okay, so we're gonna go back to the menu, and under the design menu, so I'm not sure what's wrong with this new Visual Studio, but it somehow forgets where we were. So I always have to come here and say view the design. Maybe now it will show. It's not really showing as expected, but I think most of you get the picture. So from anywhere we are, like adding cars, if we say navigate back, we're navigating back to the menu. So I'll say menu right underscore form. Can give it the same thing, go to form, menu form, then I call my variable go to form. And I say show this form and hide the one which was active. Right? And then let's check the other button which is important. I think it's on add cars. Okay, so you have already seen what to do. I'm just gonna copy this code for now and navigate back to customers now. So in customers I need exactly the same thing. So from there can navigate back to this. Seems as if I've lost my menu form, but let's run it to show you what we have so far. This is what we have so far. We're able to say add customers, it will open customers, navigate back to menu, add customers. Please note that the form just expands the size on the edges here, does not increase, it only increase at the top and at the bottom there, and the design remains the same, which makes it cool for our project. Alright, you can see this is where we're trying to get to. So now when we press add cars, we want to implement such that it takes us to the actual car form. The form we're in would be looking at adding a car. Okay, but that will now have to do on the other video. Thank you for watching this one.